Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock.
Hello? Is it better now?
Good. Are we good?
Hello? Can you hear me? Hello? Hello?
Hello, hello. All are working? Both are working?
1, 2, 3. Can you hear me?
One is not working.
Can you hear this one? Is this mic working? Or is it the other one? Hello? Hello, can you hear this?
Hello, hello. Is this on? Okay, cool.
Okay, cool.
All right. It's going to be Andy.
Maybe we should have some water to hold.
Can you ask a full glass from me as well? Especially the back.
Your screen, and it's a 17 point match. They've extended. We are now in the quarterfinals. So very excited about this match. It's going to be a good time. It's sad that they can't like both of them because both Kasten and Eric are very funny and engaging off of backhand. So while they're playing, I'm sure there's going to be a good match.
Well, I'm not sure about that. I think Carsten might be wearing his noise cancelling headset.
Yeah, actually, yeah.
Be trying to manage it.
Perfect.
Perfect.
Perfect. I made them myself.
Spanish man, you have to say.
Much about Aaron Gage.
All the best
players. Hello, the crowd. Hello, the crowd. My public
has taken some time off his
Watch the streaming of your match. You're going to be watching the streaming of your match.
No, I'm going to be listening.
That would be really.
I'm going to love pop.
And we have Andy Bell, who is joining us, who was a former partner of Eric. Your series of backhand.
No, that, you know that's okay with you.
I'm very excited.
We have the
I'm mispronouncing it. Daesh.
What? Yeah, we have the gear with you.
Now it's official.
It is official.
This one.
And by the way, the audience out there, we will only be watching the same stream or feed as you guys. We won't have XD next to us, so it'll be honest commentary.
Yes, we will maybe get things perfectly wrong, but you won't know that because it won't be evaluated until later. So just believe us, we are the Bible, we are like the eye in the sky, our word is God. Of course, these players may be playing at a 2, we may be counting 10 and 8.
You can see
but believe us. So, all right, and we are almost underway. Nope. Here we are with the 5-1.
I would just remark about Eric returning to tournaments, which is very interesting, because to have several years away from a tournament, you can easily become rusty. I mean, he's known as a money player, a poker player, a decent poker player, and a very good cash player for backgammon. And suddenly he's returned. And I did talk to him at the beginning of this event about it and concentration. And, you know, have you been studying? Nope. Well, I don't actually believe that. But you know, he's a good concentrator. So I'm sure he's playing pretty good.
We may have to go into the actual match. So far there's been a couple. I know, who'd have thought it? So there have been a couple jokers so far.
So far they're playing zero.
They're both playing zero. Eric came out, Kasten hit back. So this is mutual, not a big lead for either player right now, but the development seems to be favoring Eric if he can make a point inside.
We don't talk about who we think has an edge over either. It is an edge.
We can absolutely. We can be as partial as one would want. I was criticized by Jacek for my commentary early, obviously being biased for a player, Sebastian. So I, to be truth be told, am of course going to be biased for my Danish brother.
Well, actually, I'll talk about Sebastian Wilkinson. He's a very interesting player, a young man. He hasn't been around for a very long time, but he's playing very strongly indeed. And I noticed that quite a while ago. And he's doing it. He really is. And I'm so glad to see such a good, super strong Englishman doing it.
It truly is about time English got an actual player in that country, because it's been such a sad showing for so long. It really is amazing. But yes, I fully echo your sentiments. He's playing. I mean, he's playing relentlessly on the computer. He's really studies the game and
very good studious player. I mean, he's learned from F9 a great deal. I mean, I'd give Sebastian an edge over Fetters. Because Fetters is less on money, and Seb has a good instinct for what backgammon is, which to me, backgammon is a money game, is it not?
It's supposed to be a game for pleasure and chance.
Is it?
So again, here we I know you wouldn't recognize that as a skill game. So here we are back. Kasten rolled a wonderful 6-2 to hit Eric, and Eric's been able to anchor, and this 6-1 isn't going to slot the 4-point right, Christian?
Yeah, there's nothing else. Yeah. It's Kasten has the edge, but he's far from a cue.
Yes.
He has nothing here.
I think Eric, given that Kasten still plays relentlessly for the teams in Denmark, he's a constant player. Eric's been away from the game, as you've mentioned.
Well, I refer to Eric and his concentration. You think he could have weakened his game over this time, but actually knowing him pretty well, I suspect.
Oh, the double twos make the board and make the four.
I suspect Eric has stayed very concentrated on play and not deluded himself by being.
Oh, the four. We got a four hit possibly. But then the three is. This can get a bit hairy for Eric. Eric's deciding whether he wants to take the shot, and he'll have four loose checkers.
In a disconnected position.
It's a hard. Yeah. Well, if he hits. If he hits, then he's praying for the Kasten Bredel fan. But I think if he's hitting,
I think that's okay. And
this
it's
is
I'm not even sure it's a cube still.
You need balls.
Yes, you absolutely need balls. And as long as Kasten doesn't dance with any number.
I think it's the right play, actually.
Yeah, I think it's strong.
And it's
right play and balls.
But Kasten's thinking about the cube because he knows there's numbers here that double hit.
It's
there's
a
numbers.
Super easy take.
Yes,
super
it is.
Super easy take. I think it's an order.
And he has no drop accuracy against Eric. No drop accuracy.
Right. He's also, and he doesn't
Eric
want.
Drop, will he help?
Right. That is not good. And the 3-6, yeah. Thank God he didn't cube, because now Erica's probably going to have at least a 3-point board, if not better, depending on his roll.
Good shot. Ooh. Make the 5.
Oh, man. What about the 4? The 4's not that bad either right now.
I would just make the 5 and unstack the,
yeah,
the heavy 6.
Yeah, it's very pure, yeah.
And then if it works, then you can really have a position next roll. If you just make the 4, it's unlikely to become much better.
Right, so then you'll have 5s and 4s to cover, but you're duplicating your 4s to come up, right?
You really need to do something about that stack, in my opinion.
I do like unstacking that 6. It's so huge, and it's such a...
Yeah,
yep.
That's the right thing,
very
in
nice
my
play.
Opinion.
Does dupe your fours, but it definitely is strong, and I think if Kasten doesn't come in, Eric's got a cube next time. So
with three guys
so?
Back behind the prime, what are the market losers?
No, but look at, I mean, your four prime, his comes up.
You have three guys behind his prime,
it's
and
not it's not a nothing position.
No, but
look at this. But look at this 5-3. This does not play well.
Just make the 3.
What? No, 5-3.
Sorry,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
Prime, sorry, it's prime.
It would be nice.
Well,
Yeah, you don't want to slash on the ace, but you're now running out of checkers, and you've just given up all outfield control. So. This is one to think about. It's really nice that Eric's taking time and being deliberate.
I was watching his fingers, and they look a little bit nervous.
Yes, he does seem a bit tense. And here's Kasten 6-3. Now, as long as he doesn't get hit with a 10, Kasten's in command of this position. 6-2? No, not yet. No, you've got that anchor.
And I think the race is pretty close. Let's see.
Christian, we were being quiet because Christian is counting the race, and race in these positions is so important, especially when it comes to doubling. I don't know about easy double. I think it's a take. Yes, make that board stronger. Now it's only a 6-2 that comes out and hits. 6-4, maybe. We'd try and run the back checker. What is the race, Christian?
I didn't count. I tried, and I...
No worries. We can have a deal where
I think he needs to step up here.
Yeah, for sure. You need a flyer. Yeah.
You might have.
Right.
It's unlikely that you.
Okay, 4-3. Kasten's probably going to keep going with that checker because it doesn't really pay off that well. Start slotting right now. Eric just wants to see a set of sixes, boxes as they call them, and it'll be huge for him. All right, so.
All the boys.
The boys. And right now, Eric's
I just played to the 2, so your 5s don't break.
Yeah, you didn't. This 2 may have, that 2 may have been bad for Eric, because now his 5-1 is for any 5 is forced to. Oh. Nope.
I'll keep the prime and see if you can make Eric crack.
Yeah, if you have to give a shot late, you want to make sure your opponent doesn't have a board to contain you back. 5-1. Yep, yeah. And just like Christian said, here goes the board. Kept that 2. All right, Kasten's not really rolling the nuts here, so he's...
I would just keep the prime, have him crunch a little bit more, and...
Eric is making space.
It's also not so good for Eric that he kills those checkers in the race, which is most likely his best chance now.
Yeah, we talk about wastage, and when you have your checkers heavily stacked on the ones and twos, that actually ends up costing you and being inefficient in your bare offs and bare ins.
So Kasten is thinking about the cube here.
Yeah.
What does he do?
Yes, well.
Does he ship it?
All right, so what are we at, 30?
86 for white, plus a lot of wastage.
Well, that's
80.
Is that a 20 pip lead?
Yeah. was wasted, so he should definitely he be should cubing. Maybe he should have cubed it there. I actually think he should have cubed it. Let's see.
Oh,
that looked
a little angry, a little aggressive.
Yeah. Up yours, Ralph.
He dropped it.
Yes, he's got the double this week.
Just keep the prime.
Yep, Kasten is hoping that what, like a 4-5 something? No, it's got to be like a.
He'll probably cube him when he leaves the anchor and he gets some shots and then the volatility goes up a little bit. That's most likely where he'll cube.
Yeah, but Kasten.
I
think you should double here because you've got the numbers that cover. You don't want to give him that. Oh, and the 4-2. Look at this number. Oh,
Eric gets really bad.
Yeah, that's a very bad number.
I would just make the 5-point board and accept the risk.
Yep. So your 2 is.
And
be
you
there.
Know, there are a lot of returns if he hits it.
Yep. And if he rolls that 6-5, 6-1, 6-2, you're gonna have triple shot. So Eric is. 6-1, so triple shot.
Now the cube is coming, for
the
sure.
The cube is coming.
And it's most likely going to be a pass.
Yep. Yep. There, Kasten is presenting.
I think he...
No dilemma.
I think he lost his market,
yeah,
to
I
be
think
honest.
This is a little too good. But the race? What is the race now? I mean, Eric caught up a bit, so...
23, 25, 28...
Triple shot. I mean, what, 9 pointers?
Exactly. Yeah, I know, and that's why I love playing Chouette with you, Andy. I would love a slow boat and an Andy Bell Chouette every time. Right, and
well, you can people can falsely think.
Look, he has 27 numbers that put him on the bar, and some of those that don't are double sixes that really, you know, gin the race more or less. And,
well, look at
if you think
look at his 5-2, 5-4, 5-6 are all super jokers for Eric.
Let's see.
And he really wants to get. He really wants to. I think he wants to have that availability of a 4-cube,
but
yeah, that's it. That's it.
But
and
I
that's
guess
what
it
would happen, Andy. You would have lost. 2 points minimum.
I guess Kasten was right to wait because he still got the cube in. And
and effectively, too, because...
Yeah. Well, I mean, cube action, according to the way you think it will alter how people think about you. So in a Chouette and not a player. So last night I was in a Chouette with Mark Olsen, who is obviously...
on the Danish team, like Christian Munk Christensen, you guys should not be playing...
Yeah.
Somebody was made a comment that Denmark is the Russia training ground of backgammon players, like Russia is for chess, Denmark is for backgammon. For sure, the strongest backgammon community.
I think we have a little bit of a blurry picture now.
Oh yeah, the
maybe
somebody's been drinking
fix it or something.
Hold on 1 second. Let's.
There's an issue with the camera. It's a bit blurry.
Oh, it's focused again.
Yeah.
Oh, and we're back to being focused. All right, Eric is in, so he should easily save the gammon here.
Anyway, can I talk about Mark Olsen? Because the interesting thing is that why did he take recubes, which to a couple of players were considered massive passes? And when he recubed at 8, it shocked his opponents. Now, whether he was right or wrong, I mean, let's assume he's wrong in his cube action. So why...
Wait, why are we assuming that Mark Olsen, a very strong Danish player...
No. Okay. Let's, for the time being, assume his action is incorrect. Then why is he doing it? Well, the reason he might do this is to differ the opinions around him of other players of his skill. Although it's a considerable stakes... But
Kasten just won that easily 2-0, so go ahead.
It can damage opinions that people have of a player, so they can think he's weak when obviously Mark Olsen is very super strong.
Okay, when you write a backgammon book, Backgammon to Badass, now available on Amazon Books, you have a tendency to know who you're playing with and playing against. You guys were stunned when I came over and said, "You know that's Mark Olsen on the Danish team."
No, I didn't hear that. I didn't realize it was Mark Olsen. I thought it was Marco O.
Right, Marco Fonacer, another fine tournament director.
I do know quite a lot of players.
You do.
I mean, I know you. I know everybody.
Yes, well done. Andy Bell is giving his curriculum vitae for backgammon. Christian is being very stoic here, just watching the play. Everything's kind of everything seems pretty cut and dry.
Christian, it's wasting time.
we're having a little too much fun because I mean we have two very strong players right now. This is the quarterfinal.
I would make the 11 and just move up here, even though it's not very ideal, but you know.
Yeah, you give some of your sixes like 6-1, 6-3 end up making the 5 point with this play next roll as long as you don't get hit. But I like making the 11 and then scooting up.
Yeah, you don't have.
Ooh. Okay, so what are you thinking? You're duplicating a 3.
Yeah, that might be a play.
Yeah, I agree. That's 5-4. A
play. That is technically a play, yes.
That is a play. That is a play I would make.
Yeah.
And I still rate Eric very highly. I mean, I suspect he's playing at the high level he was playing at 8 years ago.
Yeah.
And well done to Eric for sustaining that skill.
Right. What
as
happened?
As far as I can see so far. I mean, let's find out whether he's still any good.
So right. Carsten hits here to make it difficult for Eric to develop his otherwise flexible position.
Yeah, that
so
5 and 6.
It's like a tempo
six.
Hit.
Yeah, you don't want him to have the full roll.
So come
make
in
this.
With a 3 and just make the 11 now.
Yes.
Consolidate your position and see what happens.
Carsten's
and now Carsten has this awkward checker on the ace. And
which will do nothing for a while.
So he should hit and make the ace.
Make the ace. Now it's no longer an awkward, it's a point. Not the best point, but 3 points in your board have you dance a bit. So, and Carsten definitely needed that tempo hit because there are a lot of numbers to make the 5 on his head. That would have been one of them.
It worked.
So, Carsten's looking. Carsten's very deliberate in these positions.
A bit
roll on.
At that stage.
I mean,
you've got to face a possible cube and think, oh, Christ, should I take this?
This is a take.
But this is an easy
take. And it's
easy take. But you get positions which are maybe more advanced than this, where you go, oh my God, I've got to think about this. I'm dancing through the door.
Right. Carsten's thinking.
Let's see what Eric does.
I'm not sure. Not
many.
This is a double.
I'm not sure about the double either. Yeah. But Carsten, he likes to test his opponents a
right,
little bit.
I think that's part of it. He wants to see. He's doing a heat check. You know, and sometimes he may be getting that feeling. Just like in poker, you have a feeling when your opponent looks like he's going to drop certain positions.
Yeah, that is too premature to test Eric to find out if he's still any good.
I don't know.
I'm sure. It's very early in the match to know. You might be surprised to think, Christ, Eric can still play strongly. That's a too early, premature test.
Nice play.
Because Eric
didn't he just played a 2. Oh, no, he played 2-1. Okay.
He played 8-5.
Yep.
Eric is favorite.
What?
Well, I can't quite see.
Do you want a pip count? That's a white checker, yes.
Yeah.
It's an even game. Even game. Hold
even
the cube.
Game.
I put him as a small favorite holding the cube.
Okay.
For sure.
I love you, Andy Bell. So here's a 5-4.
I think Eric should have hit. Made a bigger play. He's a real big dog in the race, and if Carsten, runs away, he's just winning.
Christian, you cannot destroy my fish right here and have him believe that he had an eval that Eric was. Well, this 4-2 definitely pays up.
Why was Eric not here? I thought he was hit.
Oh, yeah, no, that's a...
That was before.
No,
nope. Okay.
And this is Carsten just running past, and if he gets avoided, he's a big favorite in this race. But, Andy Bell, rooting for the hit.
That's
the
a big
four.
Hit.
No.
We should root for a good game. And the whole thing is
I'll play safe
starts,
here.
Yeah, you don't want to get popped with... Okay. That builder down.
It's just one extra shot by bringing down.
Double fives is the only thing you add here.
Yeah, it's 6 shots. Okay, maybe it's a tolerable actually.
Yeah, because he really wants that 5 point really bad, and he would love to get to reship Carsten or even get a gammon on. It's horrible that feeling when you get gammoned on the cube you offered, and that could happen if Carsten doesn't perform.
It's actually only 5 shots, so I think maybe he should just play
down.
Yeah, and then it's only 5 shots. And even if he is hit, then he's likely to get quite a few returns. So.
And he makes the bar, makes the 5, he makes the 3.
Yeah.
This is strong.
And it's, yeah.
But Eric's taking some time. I like that he's thinking about it. I like that this isn't just a no-brainer situation where you just... Oh.
What is he doing now?
However, okay, we're going to be very quiet in character. Yes, okay. Yeah. That part.
He's going to bring it down. He's having a good look.
Yeah, that part is for sure. You definitely need to hit there. But the three, you don't want to get heavy stacked again on the six. You don't want. You're killing
no,
a beautiful
no,
builder.
Eric, no.
Oof, this looks stiff.
I don't think that's the right
stiff.
Play. So. Yep. 2-3. So he comes in on the 3. Now he's got the 6s and 4s out. So it's not...
That's one thing I know about Carsten Bredahl. He's not afraid to make
he
a big play. He's just
no,
a very cool customer. He'll just make the play he believes is right. And
okay, actually, Eric would be no better off now with 5-2, actually, with the
oh, he would
have
been...
9 and 10 points, he'd be not much good.
He would have had the 5 points.
It was a dud number.
I don't like this play either. I would
5-2 from here.
Yeah.
It's a nuisance number.
Yeah,
so
but
it's
that's
no big deal as it happens.
I like this better than the other one he's
yeah.
looking at.
Yeah, you don't
want
to jump to the ace because
no,
you're going to be slashing at the guy.
Exactly.
You don't want that. So
let's see,
okay.
Carsten still wants to run away.
Carsten still, oh, but he's willing to build a little board just in case Eric gets some ideas.
Yeah. Let's see if he can point him in, on Carsten, and if there's a dance, then...
6-5 is not the best roll for Eric, because you do
double
not...
Yep.
Yeah. You catch up in the race a bit.
Don't leave anything.
Double slot. Good boy.
Yes. It's like he's channeling his inner... But, oh, 6-5.
Oh
yep,
God.
Yep, yep. Okay, so look, yep. Well, this is a very easy count, so... Up 8... Down to.
He's down one, I think.
It's a pip. Yep.
So now, yeah. So now he's up 8,
yep.
And he has the cube. So white is a substantial favorite now.
Right.
Just bring down those two.
I think. Yeah, you're holding
okay.
against a one.
He should try and fill the 5 and.
Yeah.
He can slow down some aces.
Yeah, but
not really. He's
Carsten's leaving. He wants
he should aim at filling in the 5 point and bring his checkers into the 6-5 and 4 points.
Yeah, you don't want to dump to the 2 and 1 when you've got all those numbers outside still.
So
6-3.
Yeah, and that's good.
That's a good play.
I like that.
Carsten's under a little bit of pressure here. He's got to roll a set. He's got to roll 6-3. Okay.
Good shot.
And
staving
one
off the
over
cube.
Average. So. Eric is looking now. He's realizing, even though he's down 2 crossovers, he's maybe slightly up in this race.
He's trailing one.
Trailing one? Okay. So it's right now anyone's game.
So
ooh.
That's now it's now equalized 2-all.
Yeah.
Most likely. Unless
yeah.
Carsten really
Carsten needs magic
responds
here.
With a good number.
He needs the boys, not the girls.
Oh,
whoa.
The boys. But this is Carsten Bredahl. He is a professional Danish champion. Two-time.
Still trailing by
Nordic
one pip.
Winner.
And with a cube ownership, he's...
Oh, Eric is being very nice and assisting Carsten in moving his heavy 5 point. Carsten says it's okay if you roll on there because it's possible your checkers are jammed up and your dice get cocked a lot when you're rolling on that side. So Carsten is...
down 3, I think.
4-2, 2 checkers off.
So now
but
Eric
that heavy
5 3.
Point is not... Yeah.
Yeah.
Not gonna be your favorite. Oh, 5-6 is very good for Eric. So Carsten definitely needs to be rolling 5s almost every time. 2-1.
So just to take it.
You should yeah. Good move, Eric. You really wanna see. It looks like 5. I don't know.
I don't think it's recubing.
That 5.
No.
If Eric rolls the 5 and the 3,
I
right
think
now,
Carsten has a better distribution and less wastage. And
Carsten's distribution is.
It's pretty good.
Right.
No, it's. I think it's better. That's okay. The worst that. It's actually. You want your checkers on the high points. The worst that can happen is that you
Andy,
roll some numbers that force the numbers the checkers
like
to go.
Point out that Andy Belb does believe that every hit is 50-50. You either hit or you don't. So it's okay that he gives this eval.
And
but
Carsten has. I'm pretty sure this is no redouble.
This is no redouble because
I predict Eric will redouble.
I don't think so.
Then Carsten is taking, and this is
this
not
is
even a
no.
Eric will correct.
Carsten also has two extra checkers off. It's
wait to double. I love that Andy's doubling down on his assessment. Okay, wait. So wait, but let's see exactly what is the cup.
Distribution is very good.
So
the race. No, it's not because.
Wait. No, Carsten's okay. So 25. Two 25 less 12. 25 less 12.
That's 13. Yeah. 10, 6, 5. He's 5 down.
Yeah, 5 down.
He's 5 down,
yep.
And he has 2 checkers less off. It's.
Carsten is taking a picture.
Oh, 5.
Yeah. It's a it's a long race.
Yeah.
Those strips, and five.
Two crossovers. Okay. Crossovers matter, and the checkers on the ace and the deuce point are gonna be borne off with. So that's the market loser.
Yep.
That's a market loser, unless Carsten does what he's good at.
6-3.
Good shot, but not good enough.
No, Eric is.
This is now double pass.
It's double pass.
I think. Let's see.
Especially when you pull out the checkers and realize, oh, that's 15, that's 14, that you're down.
Eric is just messing with Carsten.
He's either
messing with him, or he's just messing with him, suggesting that he's not capable of working out his arena.
Right. He's not able to count to 36.
Why don't you mess with people's psychology overboard? Do you mess with people's psychology overboard again?
Always, don't you? Yes.
Well, that's why I refer to
you're doing it. You're doing it right now in this booth.
It's not. We're not. You're not playing. If you're not playing a computer, it's irrelevant. But playing a human being.
Absolutely.
All human beings are relevant. Even if you're playing Moshi.
Yes.
I mean, Moshi in the World Championships last summer.
He pronounces it Mochi. I don't know if you have learned, just like the Iroquois. he is not an ice cream treat, regardless of how tasty you may think he is. So I'm.
I refer to him as Moshi. He knows it.
Yes, I know. It's amazing you have that incredible incredible French accent on the Japanese name.
I'm very impressed by that. Eric What the hell is that?
Isn't it a land animal? Like some kind of... Yes.
He's a human being.
A human being.
Anyway, let me talk back about Moshi in Monte Carlo last summer.
Oh, okay, here's a decision.
There's a five point to make between
making the 5 point or just making the ten and rescuing a blot. If you make the 5, you have a pretty awkward distribution. You'd rather make the inner board points. Yeah.
You clean up the. You clean up
I
the
don't
checker,
think it's a no-brainer. The 5 point is really big, also, and if you're hit with aces, it's not the end of the world. It's.
Nonetheless, I'm tempted, but
this looks pretty and easy
better.
To continue
anyway,
playing from here.
Can I talk about Moshi?
Moshi.
I can't say Moshi, it's ridiculous.
Right.
So Moshi, last time in Monte Carlo, he took an 8 cube and he got gammoned on it. And it turned out that his take of his 8 cube was a horrible monster blunder.
I remember that.
And I was very curious about why Moshi would do such a thing. Why would he not recognize he should let it go? And he admitted to me that he completely miscounted what the gammon potential was in this position.
All right. It's
even Moshi, oh, Mochi, whatever, Moshi. Moshi can make a mess of calculating a position.
We are humans, ultimately.
It's very interesting. I was very interested.
I think Carsten should unstack here.
Yeah, just definitely unstack.
Stay back and unstack. And
he can't come up. Look at all those builders.
I think Eric made a strange play with the ace, moving up to the 23, but it's most likely because the 8 point is stripped.
Nice 6-3 hit. Carsten wants to come in with a non 6-2. That's a 4-2 that hits. And if Carsten can see a miracle 6-3 like he rolled before banning on that board, he may have some things to think about. Nope, 2-3. A good number for Carsten to see. Eric can't hit.
Just lift.
Has to lift. Carsten can anchor with the 3. He's got a couple super jokers like double 4, 3-2.
Ooh,
very
nice.
Nice
shot.
Cleaning up. And now Eric's got a little bit of a minefield to go through.
Yeah.
And they keep hitting the camera, so it's funny to see everything tilt. Oh, that's a good question. What do you think, Christian?
I make the
outside point and slot the.
I think you. Yeah, this is a play.
Eric did it first, so that's presumably a no-brainer.
Presumably.
Yeah, I think it's good. The alternative would be to leave an ace, yeah, ace shot and then make the 2 point. Yeah. I don't think you make the 5 point there, but
what about the three?
Or did he come down with the four?
He came down with the four. Is there any merit to breaking off that anchor and trying to run? You hate to give up that dilly builder.
Yeah. He has a blot on the 2 point. That means
right.
Carsten can play more aggressively. I would not break the 11 point. Maybe he could consider coming down as on the 10, playing with the two blots. I don't know how many shots would that be.
Yeah, well, yeah, six
that's
ones.
That's
blocked.
Not too many. Yeah.
So he's got the 3-4 and the 5-2.
I would have kept the 11 point rather than the midpoint for sure.
Ugh! Look at this 3-2. This is another dumping.
Just
number.
Come out. Come out.
Yep.
He needs to come out. And that is, you know you're going to be hit, but at least Carsten is not going to be making an inner board point. And this is really bad play. Super bad play. And now he has
two. He's getting hit loose at least.
Yeah, yeah. And he has two blots and nothing to worry about for Bredale. So
what do you think about the three? Come down?
I would just come down, go all in. You know, it's
yeah. With the two loose checkers, it's very hard for Eric to come in and cover.
Yeah, he can. So. Yeah.
Oh, Carson's thinking, this may be a little rich because you really aren't getting.
You're not that concerned with being primed just yet.
No, but you don't want to see the double one, the double two, the double four, which now would crush Carsten if he gives up that anchor.
I would lose the midpoint, as Trabi says. The midpoint, that's just builders.
Right, they are just builders. It's amazing when you're playing how things turn from blots to builders to blots again, depending on the role. So, Carsten, yeah, I think this is correct.
That would be my play, and because of the two inner board blots on white side. So, big shot coming up here.
Yep, very important for Eric to not. Oh, 5-3 is.
That's,
So he's going to cover.
But I think it was
three.
Yeah.
It's a good shot, but Carsten definitely has a lot of 5 point numbers. Oh.
Yeah, hidden build. So casting. If Eric
misses, this is a cue.
Yeah, I think so too.
Double take.
I love your assessment.
Great shot.
It's not rhetorical.
How about just moving to the ace here?
Too challenging.
Yeah. Well, this is you want to duplicate the numbers that can come in and hit you, and this is one of them. So the 1-2, Carsten again. If Eric does not roll a 5 to anchor that checker, he is
then it's
he is done.
A market loss.
So Eric is that is
great,
a perfect
great
5. You don't waste any of your builders. You make the anchor, and Carsten's got a little bit of issue.
Move up,
and then safe.
And how do you save it? Should you play to 8 or should you?
Right, exactly. Do you make the? Do you make that?
This
is fine.
I think this is good. The other is a better blocking point, and
the sixes come out and play out. You have fives already. You don't want to duplicate those fives and get weird. 6-4, making the 2, or making the 4. I don't know. The 4 is a much preferred point, but.
Yeah.
You get hit with the 5, you not only do you get hit, you lose a lot of your outfield control.
I think I would make the 4, actually.
Yeah? Okay. What about you, Andy?
I have no comment, actually, at the moment.
I think it's difficult, but the problem is, the thing is, the prime is going away. This could be right. I don't know
right.
that the other play is right. But
yeah,
I think this is just going to be a little bit more tricky to develop. And
2 out for sure.
Yeah.
And then Carsten has to decide what to do with the other two.
Yeah, he should just move closer. I think he's so far up in the race.
Closer. Yeah. I do like the out. Okay, so Carsten, come on, let's play those 2 out to begin with.
Yeah.
And then.
I think he's probably counting the race just to be sure. And one thing is for sure, and that is he knows the race. So.
Mm-hmm.
He's thinking about switch or 2. That's the only thing to think about.
What?
What else is there? What are the deuces of it?
No, you're not. Not this. Well, you could play 8-4. That would probably be better if you don't. But I think this is the right play.
That's right. Okay. Yes. You don't want
to
put those.
So, I thought the only one other thing to think about is to retain the 11.
This position is going.
Well, it's worth to think about.
It is absolutely worth thinking about. But if you roll a 6 here, you're definitely out. And look at this 4. Perfect.
He runs.
He's got that checker from the back goes all the way. He gets to have a bit more control. It's only nines that hit.
I would probably not run here. I would lift. I would lift the 10. I'd just lift the 10.
You can't lift the 10. Red is on roll. What are you?
Sorry.
Okay.
Is it red on roll?
It's red on roll.
Ah, okay.
Oh, no.
It is white. Right.
Oh, yeah, it is white. Oh, yeah. Yeah. 10. Absolutely. Sorry, that's my brain fart.
That's my play. That's my play. For sure.
This is right. This is right.
You don't absolutely run off the anchor here. That's
no, suicide. No. I thought I was running the red checker just safe, and I thought it was a beautiful play. Like this. This is what I was. I was just a little more advanced.
I
knew that this play was coming, so yes. So as long as he doesn't get popped with a 9, he's in good shape, and even if he gets popped with a 9, he's got a lot of returns. 4-2.
Nice.
Eric's got a nice board, but it's a bit stiff. He doesn't have a lot of outfield tempo, and it's all fairly solved when this happens, because Kasten's leaving no shots, and now he is.
He's well up in the race.
Commanding lead in the race.
Where's the double?
Where is the double?
It doesn't. I mean, earlier he didn't double, did he, for quite a long time?
Right. So, what is it? What's the total race?
42, 45. 102 for white. 30. I didn't.
Okay, it's okay. All right, so let's look at this 10, 20, 30. I don't think it is. It's 102. It was 102 for white before this roll, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so. So it's 92. So it's 102, 92, and he just rolled 9 pips. Okay, so it'll be a pip difference. So Eric is...
Just stay put on the anchor.
Staying put.
Make the 5
and slot.
Just slot the ace.
Yeah. Yeah, you wanna get that fly shot. You want to, but still keep a checker outside in case you're forced off with a 6. You don't want to be forced off. So...
So correct for Carsten to wait.
Yes.
Yes, it's only 1 pip difference.
You two were saying double.
We were...
Yeah. It was also thought. I mean, I'm not saying you do it over the board.
No.
This is double. Then you look at it and think, oh, Christ. No.
Right. You have to take the time to look at the position.
Safety of the blood and just, I don't know, play 4-3 or something.
I think I like 3-2 a little better because the numbers fall naturally. The 5s, the 3s, the 2s reinforce. Mm-hmm. I like being heavy on the 4. I like this a little better.
Okay.
So.
That's better.
Okay, Andy. I always marvel at you. I always support the Andy Bell Baron plays. They always never cease to entertain.
Seriously, that's a play I would make. I mean, it's a very simple thing, but actually for structure.
And how would this structure look now? This would look better if you had the 5-1.
I mean, there's ludicrous discussions in Chouette, what there was last week in London, and there was a lot of betting about a very simple position, which was with Engin.
So game over.
That is. Wait, hold on a second, Andy. Eric just rolled a super joker, so Kasten has a chance to respond, and Kasten's happy that the cube didn't get shipped, and so let's reevaluate the race. Yep, there's you're up 1, you're up 12, you're up 17, less 3, 17 less 3 is 14, 12 pips in minimal contact, and this is a pass. You agree?
50, 66. So,
down 13, I spell it, down 7. Oh, wait a second, I miscounted. So,
78,
you're down
42,
one.
66 for wise.
Yes,
massive speed class.
Okay. What was the total? What was the total race? Was it 12?
I didn't count, right?
76, 78.
Yeah,
12 times. That's too much.
That's too much, especially in a no contact, and there wasn't a lot of wastage. There wasn't any transposing. Hopefully, people are looking at backgammon for the first time on these little videos that we're doing, and they're getting interested in the game. There's a lot of complexity. It's really easy to learn this game, but it takes a lifetime.
I think Carsten, he could take 8 pips down there in that race, so
yeah.
It was a good take, a good pass.
Well, vis-a-vis studying, Carter, I mean, if you play for a considerable time, when do you start to learn?
When do I personally? When I stop flying to London to play you in a cash game. Probably, that's probably... When I feel like I don't have the advantage on you anymore is when I'm going to start to really apply myself. But right now, it just feels like I can coast and just make the money. It's just like cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching. It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
I won't overstate the interest in you appearing at Stuart's London on Monday. I mean, Zephyr or interest? I mean, what do you think?
I think it's like a morbid fascination of just watching yourself be carved apart. So, okay, 5-2. Kostin's building a board because he is definitely... Is he definitely down in the race? It looks like he's down in the race. Mm. Eric is looking to point on that 5 point. Does not get it. There will be a shot. So Eric has to decide where the shot is coming from. You really want to make the 5, so I kind of feel like you're unstacking off the 6 and hitting and coming down. That is a red checker, not a white checker on the Kostin's 8. There's a little bit of glare.
Really interested in this position was the fact that
that you can see Eric's bald spot. Is that what you're? I knew that's what you were more interested in. Yes, we're all getting a little older in this time, and if Eric is going to hover over the board like that, we will make comments on.
Is he on the way out? Is it?
I don't know. You see the gray in there. You know, we're all becoming a little more wizened of veterans. You know.
Is it? I mean, in say 10 years, would it be a distinct actual patch?
I believe that it will be like a little more monkian, you know, a little more friarish. So
I think I would just play 13-8 with the 5 here instead of double hitting, and then hopefully for Eric, Carsten will roll a 6 from the bar.
Double hitting doesn't seem like the plan.
He's done it.
Yeah, you want to?
Can it be right or slightly wrong?
I think it's wrong.
You really want to hit because you don't want to mess up the 5. But yeah, this doesn't get punished.
Good, it's a good money play game.
Just
because it's disturbing. Nah. So your opponents can go, really? You seriously do that when you're
outboarded? When you're being outboarded? Yeah.
When it's not a bad play,
right?
Not at all. Maybe it's very very slightly wrong, but the shock you get is worth it.
the sheer pain when you look at
this. I don't think Carsten gets shocked easily.
Just mess with your opponent's brains. This is very good,
right?
I think it's hard to mess
so
with
that.
Carsten
oh, that ex- so that will, that explains your checker play, Andy. I was always wondering what was behind it, but you're messing with our brains. I appreciate.
Right.
Well, here is a number that messes with the brains and turns us into a 3-3 game. The double 6 is here, leaping the prime, taking the lead in the race. Kostin's got better distribution, better development. I'm pretty sure this is a double and a pass.
Just so bring it into the 4. No, it's better to have a check on the 4 than the 3 point.
Kostin, take a look.
Another one.
And yes, and overshooting his market. Maybe he's playing on for the uncubed gammon here. He's he rolled 2 more sets of 6s. Kostin's... He actually, as long as Eric doesn't roll anything substantial, Kostin may take a roll or two trying to get into what we call the weaver position, which is getting your opponent to the slow. Okay, here is a gift for you. You can turn it down.
Now I see, it's very interesting because Carsten does have an Apple Watch. So is XG on the watch?
Right.
I haven't noticed
it. It's just buzzing as it's a cube action.
Don't do that.
That's a serious conversation we should have. There is technology now that you could have people discussing, and there is a tap system on the Apple Watch that they've talked about banning certain devices in tournaments because people could technically signal. Costin, I believe, is beyond reproach. He has played for a long time, and no one is accusing him of that. But other players that I've played...
Sorry, you are accusing him of cheating.
well, is this how rumors start, Andy?
Well, I just thought, what on the street is... You think he's a cheat?
Wait, what?
Exactly. What? Carter, no.
I understand you're trying to rebuild the brand, but are we turning the WSOB into the National Enquirer right now? Yes. 3-2, very nice roll for Costin. He's 3 and he's coming up.
Yeah, that's good.
So yeah, it's interesting. There's new technology has really helped this game with the computers. People are really being able to evaluate their play better. But you're also now there is the little fears. You know, people can take a little bathroom break and go and check out match equity scores, and all of a sudden things that would never have come into play. I don't know about this tempo hit.
I think it's okay.
Yeah.
Carsten is pretty stacked, and you don't really
I think
want
that's
him.
A sort of early game dilemma when I'm playing.
It was a tricky play. I actually think it was okay.
Right. Well, I mean, it stops Carsten from so many numbers build the 5 and the 4 there. It definitely takes away half your roll. But when you get sent back, that's 24
points. The alternatives were pretty bad. You know, the alternative.
But yeah, I think Eric's got to be happy about how this turned out. He got the higher anchor. He's not as
sometimes
not as
it can be an advantage having a third guy sent back. It makes it easier to get the high anchor.
And here's the 5 points.
Yeah.
And Carsten's just moving right along. Even game. You know, the standard. Okay, Andy, what's the equity for 14 away versus 14 away? Did you go into the math
do I
for
need
me?
To explain the simple to you? I don't
no,
do that.
No, thank
it's
you for that.
Pretty close. Pretty close to 50%.
Yes, yes, yes. So.
Do you know what 50% is?
Oh yes, I do.
Do you?
The chances of you taking or passing every time, regardless.
Great
of position.
Great job, Eric.
Double threes. Yeah, yeah, I like that. You're blocking Costin's 5-6s out, which he seems to be rolling quite well.
Considering to make the 7 or the 10, and I think the 10 is a better blocking point actually.
The 10's definitely a better blocking point. And the problem is look at this play, and then Costin rolls the boxes. All of a sudden, now you've got checkers just wasted 3 on the 2 because those other ones aren't going to move.
You must make the 10.
Make the 10.
And I
think about the other two.
I also think you need to come out.
Yeah, I like that too. And Eric is hovering
over
the board.
Then there will be more pressure on Carsten Breda's blood. And
yep, you definitely have more contact. You definitely.
So
in that
it's not you know. Yes, he can make the 4 point or whatever after you leave it. But wow.
What in God's name is this?
This is not the right
play. I think that now that you have that checker on Costin's ace, you really want to come out, make the bar. You get that checker back there, gets to hold and possibly pick up some of the dumping numbers.
Now Eric has a nice position.
Yeah, this is a very nice play for Eric.
You're popping a checker down to have a peep. You just want to look at it. Have a look at it, don't you?
Yeah.
You just want to have a look.
4-2 is nice for Carsten, but nothing special.
You just want to see how it looks.
Good shot.
To doing it.
Come out. And
Come out, and now Eric's got a little more time to get around. Ooh, and the double four is luck.
That's a sort of close to Andy Joker.
It's a very close, especially because now Carsten has given up.
Joker,
yeah. He's given up his outfield control. He has. If he gets hit with a 4, he hates it. He's got a long way to go with those checkers.
Yeah.
So now those 2 on the.
I think actually I would play to 8 here.
Yeah, I think you want that spare still there.
Just play to the 8, and you don't need to run with the spare from the 18 just
right.
yet. This is better.
No, because the 6 is also
that blood is going to be gone next roll, and then you can move more freely with your spare from the 18.
Wow.
Come in to the 6 and slot the 3.
Come into the five, you mean? If he's playing in the 6-5?
I would come in 11-6
and
then just
right.
play 9-3.
Nine, nine, yeah. Okay. This is a different way to do it, and it's same amount of shots. The
I prefer the other.
The
I prefer the
You'll
other
go
one.
Yeah.
I think this is better.
Carsten definitely needs a set now, threes or fives.
Yeah.
It's a very important. Eric is going to have if he hits. Eric's very happy, and even if he misses, but if he misses with the 4-3, this isn't the best.
No.
Eric's got a. Eric's going to have a loose checker out somewhere.
He can play.
He dumped to the ace.
If yeah, that's that's three extra shots compared to stopping on the 14.
Right. 4-5.
Probably worth it. You don't really want to remove this spare from the 8 point. It's a builder for the 7 point.
Right. Yep. This is.
So one more point in the prime and.
That's the
a
one.
Good shot.
Yep.
Make the seven and then him casting in.
Yep. Now Carsten needs a 5-2 or a 5-4. And even if he gets those, he's double blotted inside.
If Eric has the same cube strategy as Carsten in these situations, Carsten.
No. This cube is coming.
It depends on the race.
Nope.
If the race is too good for Carsten, then it's not a cube. But okay, that fixes that.
Does it fix that? How bad is this race? Okay, hold on. If you want to count white, I'll count red. Okay, 50.
I would play to the six and then just in with the two blots there. Not giving anything away. That's my play.
Yeah.
Even though there are two blots in the home board, that's just a clear play for me.
Well, the nice thing about this position for Carsten is he's not forced out with the five.
44.
And unless it's a 5-6.
86 for red.
I was going to do red. That's the easy one. Come on, Christian.
Yeah, 37, 57, 64, 74, 92, 112 for white before the roll.
I don't do this.
I do it. I like it. If Carsten runs, it's...
yes, you want the back man.
Yeah, you want to have...
you're stripped.
Yeah.
Carsten wants some
better.
Kind of.
There's probably nothing in between.
He will have to. Oof.
I like this because you don't crack your board.
Wow,
you got
that's
the
big.
Returns.
You know, 14 checkers in the zone. Wait a second.
So quickly, he must just know.
Wait a
correct.
Second. Why not?
Because Eric's not cubing here. He's got the fly shot returns. Hey. Too loud?
I don't.
Sorry. Daniel is Daniel's here and he's checking out
the
action.
Play on with the dance?
I think you play.
Yeah,
on,
yeah, it's,
you play on with
it's
the dance.
It's clearly too good if.
Yeah, this is what? Wait. Okay.
It's like 16 shots.
2-6 from the bar.
Oh, well. Interesting.
Double.
You dupe threes. Dupe threes. Dupe threes, and your race isn't bad. You're leading in this race.
Yeah. That's
yeah. Yep. Moshi. Yeah. Eric's looking, but he. Yeah. Oh, that's the problem solved.
Market loser.
That is a market
Come
loser.
In and
even if Carsten comes in with the two.
It's yeah, it's too good
too
now.
Late.
It's
too
good.
Good and too late. Oh, 2-3.
Now it's no longer too good. Now it's double pass.
Now it's pass.
Double pass.
Yep.
Easy and drop. It seems that they are a little bit conservative with the cube, I think.
Yeah, well. It's so scary.
And he's now Carsten is just waiting a few seconds to. I think he's just.
But why are they being conservative with the cube at this very early stage of the match? 17 point match.
I don't know.
I mean, I would know that, to my knowledge, early part of the match, 17 points is a time to be aggressive.
It's pretty.
Be prepared to take deeper cube earlier.
I'm surprised actually. Carsten's has a lot more time than Eric right now.
Yeah, well, he's played very fast so far.
Yeah. Well, I like that he plays fast now because in the later stages he can afford to take the time, and some of the other players have run out of time.
There are different theories about what is the best clock strategy. it's obviously good having a lot of time left, or some time left, when you reach the latter stages or the last stages in the match, where the match equities swing a little bit more. But there are also those guys who spend a lot of long time in the beginning of the match, and then they have to play a little bit faster towards the end. And the reason for that is that then they know they have used their time well. If you finish the match and you have 20 minutes left on the clock, you didn't really use your resources or your time very well or very efficiently, and you at least you know you.
Oh, Eric just rolled a nice set of fours.
Yeah, just comment about time, actually, because I've heard that one particular player, talking about time, who's not concerned about wasting to low time towards the end of the match, because by that stage he's quite content to go with a lot of instinct, doesn't need a lot of time, and loses a lot of time early in the match. I mean, you've got your brain going.
5-4 is a perfect anchor for Carsten, sorry.
So you don't need to, actually, if you're wasting time, if you end up getting to the end of the match, you've only used half your time, you've wasted a lot of time. So.
But it's critical if you get up, get into, I don't know, the final stages, and for instance you need to count a race or whatever, and you don't have time to do it, and then you end up taking something you shouldn't have taken or whatever.
Your Mochy 8 cube was a perfect example. Mochy was low on time when he happened. Yeah, and that's the problem.
So it's important that you at least have time to count the race at least once per game, and then you can keep a running count from then on. I don't think neither player here plays with a running pip count, but
6-1.
Just run out.
You're wasting time on the clock. I mean,
I would run out with the front guy. Yeah,
too much time on a position which you analyze and make a choice rather than reanalyze, and undecided.
Beautiful number for Carsten right here. Sorry, double fours.
There has been a lot of good shots already in this match, in my opinion.
I knew this match would be a good one. They're both great players. They're both great rollers. And even though a lot of people say, no, luck is, everyone's lucky. Mm-hmm. And it's like, no, Andy Bell would be in the poorhouse by now if he couldn't roll out of his ass, which I think is a very important skill set to have.
I wish I could roll.
Mm-hmm. So what's a good shot for White here?
A 6-4. Yeah. That's probably about it.
That's okay too.
Yeah, Carsten's looking. No there's
double.
There's some little primey numbers, little pointy numbers, but I don't think this is quite the double. Right.
Red is up 23. Okay, that means it's a double. It's
and this is 4-2. It's not his best.
Because he's stripped outside, he doesn't want a cube.
Yeah, but the thing
you
is...
You say a cube like it's auto cube.
I think that, if you're up that much in the race and the other guy has just one checker left...
What about the 4-2? Now you've activated the gammon.
Yeah.
Is this giving 8s and 10s?
I think that's okay.
And some outsides.
But the thing is, it's what do you do as White? Do you stay back? Now he has to disengage to a losing race.
Is it that? I mean, just eyeballing this. Well, I guess, yeah, those 39 pips on his mid are pretty bad. What the heck?
39.50.
We have to see Carsten's 4-3. If Carsten is winning this race handily, then he's going to keep the checkers outside because he wants to have the time to get those final back checkers out. But I'm not sure.
Yeah, but on the other hand, the race is not gin. It's so you don't want to create too much waste. So it's like a fine balance you need to strike here. Yeah. But Okay,
Eric is now.
So now.
Yeah, I think Carsten is losing the race.
Oh.
But then again, Carsten
We've seen this.
He has a gift.
What's the odds on this happening twice. So just boxes.
Yeah. I think
boxes.
Right now, as much as Karsten has noise canceling headphones on, but yes, yep. they are now engaging each other in conversation. And I'm sure it is, what happened? I was winning. Carson's wearing his noise-canceling headphones. Ugh, and it's always horrible after you roll the nuts to roll the anti-nuts. So, 2-1 is your worst roll in a Baron.
So what have we got here? Five up. Six. White is five up.
White is five.
I don't think so.
Five up, two behind. Eight up. Four up. Seven up.
Yeah.
Five. Leading five pip.
Five pips. Okay. So five pips, one crossover down.
Crossover matters that much. I don't think it's good enough to cube here. 41.
4 pips. Carsten's taking his headphones off because he wants to either talk or engage. Five. Yep. So.
What? 72-77. Okay. With this, the wise pip, Karsten can take 9 pips down in the race, and he's only 5 down.
This is a money play.
This is a clear no double.
Very happy.
Do you double this in the
shoe-up? No. I don't know.
I think the chouette I may double this, but yeah,
it's a no double.
This match play, especially with Karsten being at.
Let's see if he gets new time. No.
Nope. Karsten's not doing any favors.
And again.
No.
Give him new
He's
time.
Like, okay, give him new time.
Eric can say to himself, well,
why?
I haven't played this one for
he should
years,
get new
so
time.
I'm maybe playing off 6 or 7. In reality, Karsten's playing off 3. So I'm going to ship cubes like this, which are tiny, tiny no doubles. I will get them going. Could say that to himself.
He could. But then he
and he is most likely a dog here. That's not the way to win by just giving away a cube like that.
Yeah.
If you think you're playing weaker,
I think you should give Karsten a bigger decision. It makes it too easy.
Right.
Oof, too easy. Karsten has just rolled.
You should get closer to the last
point
of at that position he could take 9 pips down and he was only 5 pips down, so why not take a roll and make it a little bit harder for Karsten?
Karsten has rolled his utter worst and Eric still is in that bear take.
Yeah.
So Karsten one
see,
set
see he gives himself new time but Eric didn't get it.
Yes,
yeah.
It's not Carsten's job to fix Eric's clock.
No. Why is it not bad etiquette to readjust your clock if you have a clock number?
I've seen it. That's the new rules, right? So I don't particularly like it, but yeah, you get new time if your die is cocked. Then you
really?
Can. Then
yeah,
you.
I wasn't aware of that.
Yeah.
I thought you cock your dice, cock your
dice. Yeah, yeah. That's what it used to be like, and that's what I prefer because that makes it
that
more.
That really is amazing, Andy, because I thought you'd know everything about cocking. But okay. So.
Okay, five off.
4-1.
Only when you and I are in bed and.
Yes,
spooning.
Of course. Spooning is more.
Sick. No, I don't like that ace.
Okay. Oh yeah, I don't like that ace either.
I would have played 6-5.
6-5 or even 4-3 seems like it's better on stacker. Okay. Carsten needs a set. He may be thinking 6-4.
It's not impossible, you know.
Again,
it's not
roll.
Impossible to. Eric is up 4 pips, right? Six pips up.
Six pips, 3 pips. Just this. Oh yeah, no, you're right.
Six pips.
And then Carsten one big set. Oh,
he didn't do it. 6-5. 6-5.
6-5. Yep.
So what is it now? 4 pips. Eric's up 4 pips. Good play.
Yep. Fast needs a set. He definitely needs to stop rolling those eight. Ones and twos.
Yeah, you know what, Carsten is in this race because he has cube ownership. You know, Eric has to play until the end, Carsten can finish it with a good roll.
Right.
That's worth a lot, actually. And so there will be some of the games where Carsten wins, he wins 4 points. Some of the games, Eric will only win 2 points on his wins. Right. So that's...
Chances are Eric will only be winning 2 points.
But Eric is not rolling very, very well here, so it's...
Carsten's not setting the
just 3-1, yeah. Keep a nice distribution on the high points. That's what matters.
Limping then Joker.
Six off.
Limping then Joker.
Roll the nuts any moment.
There's definitely.
Limp.
Oh, that's
good
it.
Shot.
That's a big number.
It's above average.
Yep, that's a big number.
So they have both got five checkers left.
Yeah.
I would not be surprised to see a recube.
Really? Not yet, I think. You think he needed
Let's two high numbers and Eric misses like that.
That's it.
And then if Eric misses, then we have a recube.
Yep.
This is
Carsten's getting that cube ready. I like that. Five.
So that's a miss,
and
that is now it's a redouble and most likely a pass.
Yeah. Eric had it.
This looked like double pass.
And here is a gift for
you. So this is the way to win tournaments.
Yep.
To get
and
off.
Eric knows. Yep.
So he was punished for his premature cube.
Yep. And he's into that getting punished for being premature too, I guess. Right? That's
indeed. I'm not quite used to that. I've just seen it a lot.
You've seen it a lot. Why does that happen? Who's being premature with you, Andy?
In London, I enjoy seeing punishment.
Yeah.
I'd like to see more of myself. So
yes.
I know, but I don't make mistakes very often.
But you don't make mistakes very often. That is a ringing endorsement. Andy,
so let's see how aggressively
strong,
he plays.
English player, and I love blowing him crap. But
so this could be a slot. No, he doesn't slot. I think this might be a slot.
Yeah, especially because there's so many numbers.
I think this was the wrong ace by Carsten.
Yeah. I understand splitting because maybe you get to pick
all
up
the fours are duped. I think
maybe Carsten's.
And I think the score is not enough to sway it, so I would have slotted that.
I think so, but I think he's thinking maybe, okay, so he makes the point. Oof, that's what happens. And then three comes up.
Yeah, and you don't really want to step up against that stack and you're against the better board. And so
that 6-5.
Look how much better his position would have been if he had slotted. So, okay, so now we have a cube if Carsten doesn't deliver something. Let's see, a fan is...
2-3.
He has to anchor up, and it's... I even think this might be a cube.
Yeah. It's close. It's close.
Six. There are, 11
hits.
Possible
his voice carries.
Better
your
board.
Voice carries
this
there, Andy.
Great cube. Great, very strong cube.
Yeah, I think this
And he snatched it really quickly, so I don't... I don't know. I would have thought more about the take, actually.
Oh, it's possible that's what Carsten was thinking. He's like, okay.
He snatched it really, really quickly. He doesn't have to take it that quickly.
Are you hitting with this ace? You end up duplicating your aces, his aces at you.
Yeah.
You make some awkward sixes sometimes. Maybe you get a 2-3 back game out of this. You know?
Just safety the blood on the other from the 16. I would play from the 16.
Coming around.
Yeah. 16-10 is
Carsten my... Carsten really wants to see a 3 here next roll.
But I really like that cube. That was a strong cube.
Yeah, I thought it was a very good
cube. I think
cube.
It was so strong that it... I would have thought more about it. He's really mixing it up here, taking advantage of his stronger board, but I'm not sure it's the best play.
Carsten is fine. Now Carsten slots the 5. Slots the 3. Oh, he's thinking Eric will give him...
I don't like that play by Carsten at all.
I don't know. This,
don't hit here.
Right, exactly. Not everyone went to the Mochi lecture, Christian. So
really? I would be hitting here because...
Carsten still has a bad position.
Carsten doesn't have the time to play this. You want your opponent to hit
you. Oh, that's a monster shot.
But look at his position. His strip points. I mean, you just want to dominate the outfield.
If he doesn't roll,
as has happened, Eric has primed him further.
Carsten should not hit.
Carsten is going down the toilet, as I say.
Yeah, but he wasn't...
As you say.
Right. Carsten, if you can pop a 6 here, Carsten has a little bit of time. The 2-3 game is not a bad game.
It's yeah, it's my favorite back game. It's the one that is easiest to time, I think.
Yeah.
Much easier than if you have the 24 point, and it's going to generate a lot of shots during the bear in.
It's a shot right now, unless he's breaking the eight, and if he breaks the
eight, just volunteer the shot. You're not even too concerned with being hit, you know, unless he covers the same
6-4
in the process.
Look at that hit. Ace three, also.
Yeah, so, you know, should he hit? It's not even clear.
Red,
it's not even clear he should hit.
I'm not.
I think he should probably not hit.
I would wait.
Karsten is not ready to win.
Right.
So I think that was a good play.
Yeah. The only number you're looking at is like.
So just
two, four things like
diversify
that.
The checkers there on the six, and then just play to the 12. No,
yeah.
Keep the prime. Keep the prime.
No, go ahead, break the prime. Go with your true god. Yeah, there's a. You've got to hold the prime. You're hoping
just diversify
fours,
and he's
cracks.
Thinking about duplicating aces by coming down to the 10, and I think that's wrong.
Yeah,
he could also That's what he's trying to do. He sees that 6-1 is duplicated a little bit here,
right.
But Karsten will not hesitate to hit if he can, rather than breaking both anchors or the rearmost anchor.
Karsten has a little bit of timing problem.
Yeah, he needs to spring a checker urgently.
Backgammon's very.
Don't lift that point.
Yeah, but look at where these checkers are going. So you roll that.
Keep the prime.
6-5 things like that, and you.
Yeah,
just,
but you know.
Karsten really wants a six, but a small six. 4-2 is okay. Okay, this is okay for Karsten.
So now this is the type of position where the that is like
a
joker.
That is not like a joker.
if he was cubing here, it would be too good. So it's a monster pass.
This is pretty sick. Karsten has to root for his opponent to roll like.
Yeah, the 2-3 doesn't generate that many shots in the bear off. It's mostly in the bear in. It's good.
Yep. Some of the flexibilities on the twos have gone already. So if
but on the other hand, you want to clear from the rear, right? So you need to strip down before you can clear it. So it's not. This is pretty natural development.
Yep. One, and now you have some double shot leaving numbers. 6-3, 6-4.
Yeah.
Karsten's asking, please put the checkers there so I know exactly how many I'm going against. Karsten's really looking for one of those awkward numbers that gives the double shot, and there are several available. So it's all on Eric if he can avoid this. 6-1's a great number for Eric.
Now Karsten is running out of timing, so he needs
Karsten
to run.
Karsten has to give him a two.
But if he runs from the front, then there are bad twos, right?
He's got to give a bad two. That's key. So,
and he gets.
And he found a bad two. So if Karsten can roll that 3 or that 2-1, he probably has a redouble. 3. It is Karsten Bredel.
So,
now
it's a redouble.
I think I like the 6 out here.
I think this is a redouble pass now.
Yeah, well, Eric does get a roll at it, but where's the 6 coming? Christian, are you giving him now also a bad 3?
Stay off number 1.
A bad 2.
Well, the 3 is just playing to the ace, so.
Yeah, so he still has a.
I think this is okay.
Two.
You don't really want to be, you know, attacked with double aces or something and then fanning that.
How many checkers
do
you have? 4 or 5?
I don't know. Either way, it's double
this
pass. It's double
pass
because the white checkers on the 5 and the 4 point are, you know, they're too far back.
That is a problem. There's no way this doesn't go bad. Yep, here's the 4 cube.
Clear pass. So he's stolen 2 games now.
Yeah. Okay, we're taking a little break, which is excellent because I think we're gonna get a couple of beers. Does that sound? Okay. We'll take a little bit of a break, and Karsten's leading 7-4, 2-17. The old 10-away, 13-away.
Estimate the break time.
5 minutes. You want to bet?
Okay. No, for whoever's listening. Is there a second? Anyone listening?
Yeah, they've actually had some
feedback.
Yeah. It was. Double daily.
Double the beautiful. And
that's
from that?
Well,
I thought I would give a shot in this condition, but
I do double three.
I was hoping to have like 6-7 checkers.
Yeah. Sure.
Only 4 off.
It's all.
Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And whose present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the Pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And whose present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the Pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention, whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shores. Follow us on an exciting journey through one of the most unique and beautiful corners of Europe, a place where modernity blends perfectly with the ancient. An extension of Britain in the Mediterranean, which beautifully combines the best of both worlds. A lovely town where every street and every corner have their own story to tell. A story that even dates back to the creation of man himself. And its present-day independent spirit has been shaped by victorious battles, heroes, and legends. One of the Pillars of Hercules, guarding the entrance to the Mediterranean. A special place which has captivated the soul of mankind throughout the ages. A city of reinvention whose economy is enjoying unrivaled growth, yet remains as welcoming as ever. Lose yourself in its charming gardens, old streets, and beautiful marinas, and feel the encapsulating spirit of Gibraltar become part of you. Be amazed by a place like no other, truly special, whose heart hides much, much more than you can imagine. Dominating the horizon at the southernmost tip of Europe stands a majestic Jurassic limestone rock, rising up into the blue skies and gentle winds. It is the very heart and soul of Gibraltar, this small yet symbolic territory, towering above the gateway to the shimmering Mediterranean Sea. The sunlight reflecting off the rock is like its people, warm and friendly, like the gentle breeze rolling off the sea, softly caressing the sandy shore.
The best match we have seen so far.
Absolutely.
Right.
Yep.
We agree?
Yep. Oh, and by the way, we also like the way you're playing. There are a couple of plays that we felt, because you're more of a cash game guy, that you were playing really more of a cash game.
Oh, the 5-1 beat twice? You didn't like that?
I think it was
just tricky. What would you do, like, Scott?
I think the slot was really good. He had all the development builders to just go.
What did he do? Why he rolled double four from the bar? He rolled double four from the bar on this one.
Right.
Yeah. Missed, but when he misses, not with anything. With double four. Okay, all right.
2 hours later, double six.
Yeah, yes, double six. Boom, boom, come on ahead.
It was like,
so I was right to hit, right?
And then
I thought I need to stop the guy. Two on the bar, but see, 2 hours later, the race is over.
Can you say, David, can you tell me all the backgrounds of LS. I need to report them for my original.
It's how is it? It's the bad. That's how he falls asleep at night. His opponents, the bad luck stories that he falls asleep to them.
I'm a lot of these two. Alan, you should read them on my blog.
Where you pronounce it on Twitch?
Yeah, sure.